Yeah, you are.
Ah, so good of you to finally join.
Yep.
You do realize you're 5 hours late. You're first place. Okay, come inside. Have a squat over here. And open your notebooks on page one. Today we're learning HTML, building blocks of the internet. So does anybody know what does HTML actually stand for? Anybody, come on, take a guess.
Oh, me, teacher. Teacher!
Yes, you!
Can I go to bathroom?
But we just started!
No, you see, this class is going on for 5 hours already!
Just go... So, HTML, who knows what it stands for? What is the internet written in? Yes, you again!
It is Hotmail! No! Hate mail! No! Hatmail!
Hatmail, yes. By far the best case we have had. And today we're learning Hatmail!
Yes, Boris!
HTML or Hypertext Markup Language is the building blocks of the internet. It is the base of every website that you visit. It is the language that your web browser understands and can show you the content that you request. Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer 7 if you're crazy, they all basically do the same thing, giving a visual representation of the code that the page was written in. Let me show you exactly how it is done. In my previous programming videos, I have shown you that you need specific programs to write this code. I think I used PyCharm for Python and Eclipse for Java. But when it comes to writing HTML or the accompanying JavaScript or CSS, I talk about those later, you basically do not need any programs at all. You need a browser and a text editor. That is all. But when it comes to the text editor, I do have a couple of suggestions. Instead of just using Notepad, download Notepad++, even if only for the possibility to change to dark mode theme. Nice. It is basic, it is lightweight, and it is free. But if you want something more beginner friendly, choose for example Atom. It has many functions out of the box that you will get used to using very fast. Also very lightweight, so works on basically every machine. And it is free. This third one, Sublime Text, very powerful, good for working with very large projects and a lot of plugins, and also costs money. And if you're just starting to learn HTML, a bit overkill. Choose your weapon, I'm going with Atom. No, many tutorials insist on starting with HTML, CSS, JavaScript,
SQL, PHP, JSTKS, Ruby, C#, Unity.
Today, we start with one and finish with one, because that is how it is supposed to be. HTML is by far the most important thing that you need to comprehend when you're starting out with web programming. If a web page is a house, then HTML is the bricks. It holds everything in place. CSS is the wallpaper, make things look nice. And JavaScript are the windows that open and the lights that switch on. So today, we learned the bricks. The brick house, the brick chairs, the brick cooking. Yes, video coming soon, I promise. All the way to the bricked-in windows that we can replace later on. Let's start from the top. Let's start laying the foundation. Make a new file and save it as my brick house. .html. When you save it as HTML file, the text editor will know what you're doing and suggest actions that speed up your process. This is the encoding of the file. Normally you not need to change it, but now you know where it is. Writing HTML is pretty much like writing any other document. But instead of just slapping words into a file, you have to teach your browser through this file to show things correctly. Let me show you. Just write in HTML and press enter. If you're using Atom like me, then it will do a lot of work for you, but if not, you have to write it yourself. First, do a wall. If you do not know where the angle bracket key is on your keyboard, please find it now, because you need it a lot. HTML consists of text. These are text written in angle brackets. Let's simplify this document. It's a bit too much noise right now. And start from the top. Angle bracket, HTML, and close angle bracket. This is what is called an opening tag. Inside the tag you can write something, but all tags have to be closed. To close a tag you write bracket, slash, and the same tag name, and close bracket. Write whatever you want inside, and we are done! With pages read, you're hired! No, literally, that is the main thing you have to realize about writing HTML. Tags open and tags close. The rest is basically memorizing what every tag does and which parameters you can apply to the text. Una, that is the fun part. I get to that very soon. But first, if you want to see the progress that you have made on your HTML file, you click save, Find the file that you have made, double click to open, and it will appear in your default browser. Do not worry, this is not the internet. People cannot see the mistake you're making. The browser simply is playing a file on your hard drive. But let's say you're not exactly happy with this website that you have made. It only has 2 words, a lot of white space coins and news, and instead of Brick House Productions, it just shows the file name on top. It does not exactly scream production value. For example, if you go to YouTube, it does not say my video site.html, it says YouTube. And why should our site be any worse? We fixed this, no problem. To add a site title to your page, we need to use the title tag. But the title tag needs to be in the head tag. Why not? Gets confusing. Well, not really. You just need to remember that an HTML document starts and ends with HTML tag. Let's call this level 1. Inside the HTML tag, let's call it level 2, you are allowed to write 2 tags only. Head and body. Bracket, head and bracket. Leave some space and bracket slash head and end bracket. Now, as you can see, I'm using the tab key to give myself a visual representation to see on what level I'm writing this stuff on. You do not need it, HTML documents do not need tabs at all. It just helps to keep track. Now inside the head, let's write title tag and some room and end title tag. And inside this tag, we write whatever we want. Save document, refresh page, Brick House Productions, not just look professional. Congratulations, you are now overqualified. Fun fact, if you take any site at all, you can always check the HTML that it was written in. It's an easy way to cheat off someone else's work. Let's check Google, for example, I hope they do not mind. If you're using Chrome, right-click anywhere on the page and click inspect. Or just press F12. The same shortcut actually works on Microsoft Edge and Firefox as well. And now you should see some familiar tags. Yes, this is HTML. Here's the HTML tag, here's the head tag. In the head tag there should be, let's search for it. Yes, the title tag. And it shows the name of the site. Now this section is the appropriately named developer tools. It lets you make temporary changes, writing the source code to see how things would look. Like instead of going to the text editor again, changing title of page, saving, coming back, refreshing, you can instead just write whatever here. And it will show you how it will look. Ой, блин, Ирина. Google to whatever again. Come on. Oh, boy, yeah. Also, you might be wondering why these languages and this location keep switching. This is just something that I do when I'm online. I'm switching between VPNs, which is, by the way, today's sponsor as well. NordVPN, by far the cheapest and fastest of the VPNs that I have used. Long gone are the times that you need to be some government spy to need your movement on the internet to be encrypted. Instead, everybody now has the chance to stay anonymous on the internet. Modern time need modern solutions. You need to appear from Argentina? Boom. Done. Check link in the description, nordvpn.com/lifeboris. Get 68% off the 2-year plan. And of course, 1 month for free when using the code LIFEOFBORIS. No problem. No matter if you believe in scary fairy tales about internet thieves or not, your movement always leaves a trace if you're not protected. Блин, how you take a stay anonymous for 5 years straight? It's VPN, man! Gone are the times of downloading security programs that take forever to load, contain enough bits to fill a copy of War and Peace by Tolstoy, and only work half the time at speed of snail. A slow one! So check link in the description, nordvpn.com/lifeboris, and upgrade your online experience to invisible. Boris approves. But what internet is there at all if we're only stuck on the title tag? And this is what we have the body tag for. The body tag, just like the head tag, goes inside the HTML tag on level 2. You write it like this, bracket, body, and bracket, leaves of space, and bracket, slash, body, and bracket. Now it not matter how much room you leave in here, you will be expanding the inside of this body tag indefinitely. Because there's the stuff in the head tag, just like the title and the extra stuff I show later, is shown outside of the page, then all the things in the body tag are shown on the actual page itself. Now yes, if you have been paying attention, you will note it at the beginning of this video. I showed you an example with that head or body tag at all, just HTML and some text, and it worked. Which is because your browser actually helped you out. Well, let me show you, if you write a document just like this, HTML tag and just some text, you save it, reload in browser, and the developer tools, blin, what do we see? A head and body tag automatically generated. That is because without this text, the page is not valid. And we want it to be valid. We want to be the next social network, blin, the Slavbok. But unfortunately, you cannot tell your browser, hey, just build me the next $1 billion business. You need to build it yourself, and this is how you start. As I said, in the body goes all the content. Headings, paragraphs, tables, images, videos, buttons, forms, whatever you want. For example, testing the time rating is H1, it is the heading of the biggest size. Works just like every other tag, just write welcome to Slavbook. What about some text, yes? The P tag means paragraph. Yes, you could just write your text inside the body with no P tag whatsoever. But you will see in the paragraph tag, the text looks much better out of the box. And when you're writing CSS or styles, paragraph tags are much easier to work with than loose text. This last one is a link. The tag for link is the letter A. You write a tag, write something inside, and you close it like that. But what is this? This is all in the same line. This is not allowed. Well, actually it is. Let me show you. But first, let's finish building the link. A link requires an attribute to work. The href attribute. You write like this. A space href equals quotation marks and then close bracket. Quotation mark very important. This is where you write your link. Or if you do not have a link yet, you just want to see how link look on your page, write here a small hashtag instead. But I will put the homepage of Google. And this you have to write with the full address with the HTTP. And then it is good. One big heading, some text in a paragraph, and the link. And the link is working good. As homework, you're going to clean up your document and make it look like mine, where the title, heading, paragraph, and link are all single line elements like mine. Good luck, I will see you in the next lesson. I said thank you for watching, and of course, stay cheeky-breaky.